Alltså den här, så jävla
get ready.
So guys, just as a courtesy, nobody should really be here while we're shooting this. So just as a courtesy, just head back that way, please. And out.
The day has finally come for when we're shooting Fire Fade, which is the second chapter of Ladywood. We shot Fairdust almost about a year ago, and I've been trying to make Fire Fade happen, and now it is, so I'm really fucking excited. Fire Fade is the darker, more moody part of the album where the sweet escape isn't so sweet anymore. It's almost like that second rush is starting to wear off a little bit. We're like, fuck, you become aware of yourself, of your insecurities, of your struggles, and you have to like realize things about yourself that you might not be that excited to realize. So I was screaming yesterday, I was pissed off and I was angry. As soon as I feel that emotion, I use it to express things. And Tim is cool with me screaming at him because he knows it's what I want out of myself too. So he knows that it's not aimed at him really. But I think we might have freaked people out a little bit. Tim and me create things together in a way that like I just feel fully comfortable with him showing any like weird side of me that I want to put out there. He's like on and he gets it. And when he showed me this idea of like we should just have like a tilting room that is like the world around you might be upside down and you trying to figure out like who the fuck you are and what you're feeling, but then with light and just me moving and expressing different things and working with Tugi, amazing choreographer who teaches a lot of improv classes, which is perfect for this. I remember we were shooting one scene and I was doing the sexual moves, this where I'm like, this I get, I can play with this. And then she just calls out, she's like, dare to be more ugly. And I'm like, oh yeah. She's like, more of like, show that side, like the demon side, the side that you're not proud of. I'm like, fuck, yeah, I have to do that. All that I'm trying to use and act out in the different songs while the room is spinning and while I'm trying not to step on the wrong furniture that will break my foot or my neck or whatever.
I was so focused on the moves more and just fucking room moving.
Yeah. Not dying.
Yeah.
Not dying.
Just focus on not dying.
For me to crawl around on the roof looking like a spider or like a demon child, you need to build a fucking cylinder and you need to build a whole new room and to like glue everything so stuff doesn't fall and hit me in the head. It's so amazing for me to see how many people it takes to get something perfect and to make it visually what you want, how much time and process and you know goes into it. But it's been so fun and cool and probably the physically most exhausting thing I've ever done. More day today, shooting the non-spinning room and I think another one where I'm gonna do all my weird nursery rhymes.
My name is X-Baby, X-Baby, chicka chicka, boom boom boom, Charlie Chaplin, Chaplin Charlie, I love you if you love me.
We're gonna show that in a very twisted, trippy way. What the Fuck Love Is, this is gonna be the only song that is actually still, where the room is not spinning. With me kind of joining these hooligan looking hard expressions on their face, just a little bit, you know, violent energy. They're gonna have their own little like room party and I'm gonna join. And it's kind of showing that I'm the one taking charge in a sexual situation, taking the lead, being less of the traditional female role usually. But in this scene, we wanted to make it, you know, not seem as you're encouraging violence.
Her choking you.
If you're okay with it, check it out.
They're fine with it.
Do you feel okay with that? Like, yeah. Definitely. All right, good.
It's also about showing that moment of like, you know, kind of being submissive too and like kind of, you know, needing someone and like knowing that you're treating yourself bad but still putting yourself in that situation. Again, Ladywood is a two-part album, and I'm finishing the other half of the album right now that will come out later this year. It's 4 chapters total, and I want to create a short film to each one. Didn't realize after the first one that there's going to be so much pushback to create the second one, but we made it happen anyway. This is fully funded by me, and Tim obviously will take a few hits of this as well. In a way, it's better this way because we get to do exactly what we want. We were talking about, you know, Fairy Dust was still pretty dark, but it had more of that like light escape vibe to it too. And Fire Fade should be internal me just battling all the different feelings that I now finally have to deal with. And it's almost like I'm pushing it out of me and then like fucking up the environment around me and making everything just shift because I can't explain them or I can't get to the bottom of them. And it's that like, hey, no, don't come in right now. We're doing interviews. Oh, everyone here is great. It feels really cool to have created a body of art, you know, a body of work that it's like an art piece, and it's my story. This is very narcissistic too, obviously, but it's my story and my love story and my like feelings that are just now created and out in the world, and it's always going to be there. And all my fans turn to it too because they feel the same way I do or they relate. I get so many amazing sweet letters where it just says that like, oh, these songs made me accept myself and made me love myself and made me feel okay about being sad sometimes, made me feel okay about being heartbroken or whatever it is. And that really means something. Yeah. All my fans, I know you've been waiting a long time. I'm very happy to be able to give the second part of Ladywood to you. Fire Fade, I hope you will relate to it, love it, feel it. Might scare you a little bit, but I know you'll get it. See y'all soon.